right, guys, so what we want to do here today is look at finding the distance between two points on the coordinate plane. We're going to do this graphically. This is my preferred way of finding the distance because it uses the Pythagorean theorem and it doesn't focus so much on the distance formula. The distance formula is a totally valid approach, but I think it is much simpler if we use a component-based approach with right triangles. So let's have a look and see what that is. So we're in, this is in Delta Math, distance formula graphically. I'm going to work with my tools here, and then I will complete the problem in Delta Math. But first, we're going to use the tools I have for writing on the board. So anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to draw the components. So it says graph a right triangle with the two points forming the hypotenuse. So what that means is we're going to take from each of these two points, and we're going to drop a horizontal and vertical component to the triangle. So here's the one side, okay, so the bottom, and then little spinning wheel there always seems to be showing up when I'm doing these videos. I'm sorry there. Okay, so now here's the other one. All right, so you notice that they intersect at a right angle here. Okay, so that's very important. Now we're literally just going to count. All right, so from negative 1 to positive 7, let's get rid of a little bit of this line here. There. So we're going from negative 1 horizontally to positive 7 horizontally. And so that's 8 units. All right, that's so the x component is 7 minus negative 1. Whoops, negative 1, all right. Oh boy, lots of lag, which is 8. The y component goes from 7 through 2. So this y component here, this is at 2. So there's 5 units between 7 and 2. So the y component is 5. Y is 7 minus 2. All right, which is 5. Okay, so now what we're going to do is calculate the distance using the Pythagorean theorem. Remember, the Pythagorean theorem is c squared, equals a squared plus b squared. I like to write it this way because I think it translates more easily into calculations, especially if you're trying to find the hypotenuse. This puts the variable on the left-hand side of the problem from the very beginning. Now, what we're actually trying to do is compute the distance. So c squared is really d squared. And then a will be x, and b will be y. Holy cow. I said the lag is really, really nuts right now. Okay, so here we go. D squared equals x, which is 8 squared, and y, which is 5 squared. All right, so d squared, holy cow, is 64. This is nuts. 64 plus 25, I'm sorry. And that's 89. I am not going to write that d squared line again. So this is where things are going to get complicated for you guys, because this particular lesson does require you to be able to reduce square roots. So you need to reduce the square root of 89 to its simplest form. All right. Now the process of figuring out the 89 might be prime on its own. I don't know if it is or isn't. 7 might go, 7 go into it? No, 7 doesn't. This might be prime. The answer might just be d equals the square root of 89. Basically, you need to do a factor tree on the number. And for the life of me, I can't think of any values that might go in. I mean, 3 doesn't go, 4 doesn't go, 5 doesn't go. 6 doesn't, 7 doesn't, 11 doesn't, right? Because 11 is 88. Yeah, this might be prime. Okay. Oh, boy. So if it's prime, then we're done. The square root of 89 is the answer. Let's find out. Here, it'll be fairly... Okay, so square root of 89. Keep that in mind. All right, so we're going to draw the line here. Now we got to do it on the graph to complete the problem. There we go. So now it's going to let me answer the questions below. Okay. Leg 1 is going to be 8 units long. Leg 2 is 5 units long. And the hypotenuse is the square root of 89. Verify the solution. How'd I do? Oh, I got it right. Okay, so the square root of 89 was prime. That was nice. Nice of square root of 89 to be prime. All right, so we look at the answer here. They're doing the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, they find square root of 89 doesn't simplify. So just as a note here, okay, some square roots do simplify. So for example, if we had done that problem and we came up with the answer, the square root of 48, all right, what you want to do is try to figure out what the factors of 48 are. So easiest way is just to start with 2, right? 2 times 24. Okay, does 3 go in there? It does. So 3 times, what is that? No, it doesn't. Yeah, it does. 3 times 16? Is that right? Yes, math in my head. I'm not good at it. 4 times 12. 5 doesn't go. 6 does. It's 6 times 8. And I think that's it. So when you look at these problems, then you want to find the biggest perfect square you can. So like 16. Okay, so then I can break up the square root using 3 times 16. So this would be the square root of 16 times the square root of 3, basically. So you're using this line right here, 3 times 16, and you're writing it as this. Okay, come on, tools. All right, so 4 times the square root of 3 then would be the answer. Okay, so just remember, that's how you do that. You have to do the factor tree on the number, and then you're looking for the biggest perfect square that you can find inside the factor tree. Take the square root of that number. Whatever's left over stays inside the radical. We're good, okay? So again here, you're just perfect square, biggest perfect square you can. All right, rewrite it in radical form, and then take the square root of that number to get your answer. Okay, there you go. I'll see you guys on Wednesday. I'll see you on Wednesday.